Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adlai Aiste, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Don't Kill Yourself. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Exodus chapter 20, verse 13. It says, "You shall not murder." Children, one day, a young man stopped his car on the busy Golden Gate Bridge. He got out, ran over the railing, and stood a moment in sight of several people. Before anyone could reach him, he leapt to his death. Who killed him? You answer, he killed himself. Most boys and girls know that one of God's Ten Commandments is, "Thou shalt not kill." But you don't have to shoot a person with a gun to kill him. The human race had not yet invented guns when God gave this commandment. The young man who jumped from the Golden Gate Bridge was just as dead as if he had been shot. Consider this question. How quickly must a person die in order for it to be said that you killed him? Must death be sudden? What if you use small amounts of arsenic or strychnine to poison a person? That would be a slow death, as if he had been killed instantly. What about smoking? We are told that there are 17 poisons in cigarettes. When a person smokes, is he not slowly killing himself? He is surely risking the very real danger of developing cancer. Thousands of people die each year of lung cancer or emphysema. I watched my own father die of this awful disease. The doctor had been urging him to stop smoking for 5 years. "It is killing you," he said, but Dad only laughed at the idea. It is so easy for a person to shrug his shoulders and think that it can't happen to him. When he was on his deathbed, it was no longer a loving matter. He told me, his teenage son, with tears, "Oh, how I wish I had never started smoking." Right then and there, I determined in my heart that I would never smoke. Children, Daniel decided that he would not defile himself. And so did I. And I can say that a cigarette has never touched my lips in all my life. I have kept my lips and my life clean for God to use. In our DMV pledge, we likewise determine to keep the DMV law, and that involves the entire law of God, all 10 commandments, including the one that says, thou shalt not kill yourself or others. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, today let us make a decision to obey all of God's laws, namely the Ten Commandments. Like Daniel, who decided not to defile himself. Children, today ask Jesus to help you guard your heart and promise to keep the commitments you have made. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.